everyone. If you are looking for a tool to make tutorials for your audience or record simulations for your training, you already come to the right place. In this video, I could give you short and clear explanations on how to record interactive simulations with ActivePresenter 9. If this is your first time watching video in our YouTube channel and you don't know what is ActivePresenter, so here it is. ActivePresenter is a fantastic authoring tool to create e-learning courses, record screen, and edit video. Before coming to the main part, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell icons for new updates from us. In simple terms, you can understand that record interactive simulation is equal to record all on-screen operations. For example, when you left click it or you open a new page, blah blah, and it will convert into slide in ActivePresenter 9. At the same time, each operation would have a mouse click annotation and a feedback message attached. Okay, so first you can launch the record interactive simulation feature like this. There are two ways you can start the record interactive simulation feature. First, you can go to the start page and click interactive simulations. Or in the workspace, you click the ActivePresenter button on the top left corner and choose record interactive simulations. So after selecting to record, a blue border rectangle and the record interactive simulation project dialog appear. You can see you can drag the blue rectangle to anywhere on the screen to specify the recording area manually. Okay, so in the recording area section in here, you can click the full screen to record the whole screen or select custom to record a specific area on the screen. And then you can click the drop down arrow next to the size spins boxes to choose a preset size. So GIF won't give you many options of the size from small to full HD. And if doesn't sort of satisfy you, you can select customize to add and edit the sizes you wish. And then you can tick the lock to the applications checkbox. And if you want only to record a current operating applications, and also it gives you two options, feed to boundary and feed to applications. Next is the audio sections. You can see you can choose to record audio while recording it or not. And if you want to record audio, click the microphone icons to turn it on. And once the icon turns green, it means it is enabled. And afterwards, you can click the arrow next to it to choose an audio input. And it allows you to record audio from a microphone or the system simultaneously or separately. So you can also drag the thumb of the volume slider here to the left or right to decrease or increase the volume. So there are two things you need to be aware in here. And the first one is you cannot record the webcam while recording interactive simulations at the same time. And also the second is it is better not to record audio and simulations at the same time, since the recorded audio files may appear in different slides. And after your simulation is completed, record your voice instead. After being done with those settings, you can click the rec button to start recording based on the area that you have set up, and then wait for 3 seconds to start. You can stop the recording by pressing Ctrl N for Windows or for Option Command 2 for the Mac OS, and then click the stop button in the recording toolbar dialog. And then you will see a series of slides containing the step that you have taken in the slides pane. And then a slide-based project results from all actions on the screen here, and slide names can be automatically created by ActivePresenter, as well as smart annotations, cursor parts, mouse clicks, keystrokes, and feedback messages. And at a result, you can save yourself a lot of time and effort during the editing process. So after finishing, you can export your projects to various output formats, and you can see here the most suitable one for interactive simulation is HTML5. And with HTML5, user can easily view and interact with the content. In case you want to create a training document, you can export the projects to Word, Excel, or PDF format. And also, you can export to images or videos if you like. Now you are getting on the gear to wow your audience with ActivePresenter. Download ActivePresenter with the link provided in the description box to try on your own. Now, goodbye and see you in the next video. Thank you.